What I want to show you today is I want to show you a very important part of macroeconomic stability, something called the money transmission mechanism. And if it sounds like a mouthful, I'll give you a brief synopsis of what I'm doing. This is an aspect of monetary policy. And you've read about monetary policy from your textbook. It's when the Federal Reserve engages in active policy to stabilize the economy. So this is a hot topic right now in the news. You hear all of this stuff about the Fed and interest rates. This is going to show you exactly how this particular type of policy framework works. It's something called, let me get it up here, the money transmission mechanism. Sounds like something you do to your car, but it's not. It's about stabilizing the economy. Now, monetary policy pretty much uses the money market. The Federal Reserve is trying to move interest rates in a particular way that will get the economy stabilized. And I'm being very brief about this because I want you to go and read the rest of monetary policy in your textbook. Now, how this works is, as I said, the Fed is using what's called the money market. So I'll start at the beginning, the money market right here. And what do you think is happening in the money market? If you're thinking this is some place you could go downtown LA and get some money, that's not what it is. It's basically just like any other market where we have a supply and a demand for money. Okay? So the money market has a supply and a demand. Think of a market for milk. People buy milk, people want milk. It's the same thing with money. There's a supply and there's a demand. And what the money market looks like is this. Here is the quantity of money. I'm going to call it QM. And then we're going to have the price of money. And the price of money is something you're very familiar with. The price of money is the interest rate. Little I. Okay? So the money market is being used to stabilize the economy. You have a demand for money. Here is MD for money demand. And you have a supply of money. Here is MS for money supply. And that's the money market. Right where demand and supply meet, you're very familiar with this. Where we have supply and demand meeting, we have a name for that. It's called equilibrium. Right here. And I'm labeling that I star and QM star. So let me recap. The Federal Reserve is using the money market to stabilize the economy. The question is, how are they doing this? What are they doing? When you listen to MSNBC and Fox News and NBC or whatever, how exactly is the money market being used to stabilize the economy? The Federal Reserve is using some component in the money market to get the desired change in the interest rate. Now think about this. The Federal Reserve is not a government entity, but the Federal Reserve is a quasi-government entity whose job it is to stabilize the economy by targeting interest rate. So what would the Federal Reserve be trying to manipulate in the money market? Would they be trying to manipulate money demand, or will they be trying to manipulate money supply? And I want you to think about this logically. The Federal Reserve, okay, the quasi-government agency, what do they have control of? Do they have control of how much money is demanded, or do they have control of how much money is supplied? And if you're thinking, who is demanding money? I know I am, and you should be too. So does the Fed have control of our desire for money? Or do they more so have control of the amount of money that can actually hit the economy in terms of supply? If you're thinking it's supply, you're absolutely right. So how the money transmission mechanism works is the Fed is targeting interest rate, manipulating the money supply in some way, shape, or form. Your textbook will tell you how to get a desired change in the interest rate. Okay? Manipulating the money supply to get desired changes in the interest rate. So we don't stop here. We start here, and then we end up stabilizing the economy. And this is where the transmission piece comes in. How does this work? So we start off with the money market, and then what? Well, the money market is going to manipulate the interest rate, and that's going to have an effect on investment, okay? And notice I'm drawing the graph side by side. You do the same thing because you want to see how it flows when you draw it. So let's set up the investment market. We're going to put investment here. And the Fed is manipulating the interest rate to get a desired change in investment. This is the investment. Now watch it. Here is the interest rate in the money market. Whatever it is, it can be traced to the investment market. So this is the I from the money market. This is the amount of investment that it generates. And things should be kind of, sort of, becoming a little bit clear to you. Because I want you to think about this. If the Fed is trying to stabilize the economy, they're trying to fix one of two problems. Not 99 problems, but one of two. They're either trying to fix inflation, or they're trying to fix a recession. So these are the problems. Inflation or recession? Now think logically. If we're going through, we're going to start from the bottom up. If we're going through a recession, what would the Fed be trying to do with money? Do they want more money in the economy, or do they want less money in the economy? So if you're trying to fix a recession, more money in the economy would fix that, or less money in the economy would fix that? It's more. If you're going through a recession, there's a downturn in economic activity, which would mean to fix it, get money in the economy. So when we have a recession, they engage in what's called expansionary monetary policy. How does that work? Recession, get more money in the economy. If we want to get more money in the economy, and when I say get more money in the economy, I mean the Fed, the money supply increases. That's why I'm doing this. MS1. Watch what happens to the interest rate. It drops here. Let's call it I1. So when we have a recession, the Fed engages in expansionary monetary policy, and that's more money in the economy. That drops the interest rate. Now watch this. You remember the transmission piece? Dropping the interest rate, look what happens on the investment market. You get more. More investment. So we're going through a recession. The Fed finds a way, and we'll get into the mechanics, or your textbook will get into the mechanics, but the Fed engages in monetary policy, expands the money supply, shrinks the interest rate, and look at investment expanding. That's perfect if you want to fix a recession. In fact, it's so perfect, you could show how exactly it would be fixed in the economy. This is called the economy. I'm going to show you how it fixes it. This is the price level. That's the GDP we talked about earlier. Here is the aggregate supply. And here's the aggregate demand. Fed goes in, gets the money in the economy, dampens the interest rate, investment expands, and aggregate demand expands. Look at the GDP going up, moving on up, like George Jefferson. And isn't that great if we're going through a recession to get the GDP going up? This is expansionary monetary policy. This is what the Fed engages in. Now, the problem we're going to be trying to fix with the money transmission mechanism is now when the Fed is trying to fix inflation. Now, how does this work? Let's set it up. Again, we start with the money market. And the money market, if you remember, has the quantity of money and the price of money, which is the interest rate. Here is the money demand, and here is the money supply. Very good. Now think, we're going through inflation. Inflation is when there's too much money chasing too few goods. Too much money in the economy. And I'm making this very obvious. If there's too much money in the economy, what would the Federal Reserve be trying to do? Put money in or take money out? If you're thinking, that's pretty obvious. If we're going to inflation, the Fed wants to decrease the money supply, take money out, which means the money supply looks like this. Now watch. Now that we have the money supply, and I'm calling it MS2, decreasing, look at the interest rate. Now it goes up. Now remember the link. We move from the money supply to the investment market. What does it do when interest rate goes up? Well, let's see. We used to be right here. Dropping the money supply, which is what's appropriate during inflationary times, then the interest rate goes up. Look at what happens to investment. It's dampened. We go this way. If you're going, why would we want to decrease investment? Well, we were going through inflation. That was too much money in the economy. And if you want to see what it looks like in terms of stabilizing the economy, let's set up the real economy right here. Here's the GDP you're used to, and there's the price level. There is your aggregate demand, and here's your aggregate supply. If you dampened investment, then you made aggregate demand drop. How is this fixing the economy? I want you to look at what the price level was before. It's right here. When you get the interest rate to go up and you drop the investment, you lower aggregate demand. Watch it. Look at what happens to the price level. It goes down. Isn't that appropriate during inflationary times to get prices to drop? That's perfect. Inflationary times, you engage, and we have a name for this. This is called contractionary monetary policy. Okay? So contractionary monetary policy. That's what the Federal Reserve engages in via the money transmission mechanism to fix inflation.